नमस्ते, वेलकम टू दिस फिफ्थ योगा सेशन एंड दिस सेशन इज स्पेशली ऑन प्राणायाम प्रैक्टिसेस, ब्रीदिंग प्रैक्टिसेस, प्राणायाम, मुद्रा एंड बंध. ओके, देर आर डिफरेंट प्रैक्टिसेस इन द ट्रेडिशन ऑफ योग. सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विथ प्रेयर. सिटिंग कंफर्टेबल एंड स्ट्रेट, आईज जेंटली क्लोज्ड, हैंड्स इन नमस्कार मुद्रा प्रेयर पोजिशन. Slowly inhale. Om Sahanavavatu Sahanau Bhunaktu Sahaviryam Karavavahai Tejasvinavadhitamastu मा विद्विषावहै. ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः. स्लोली रिलीज योर हैंड्स, कीप योर आईज क्लोज्ड एज इट इज, सिटिंग कंफर्टेबल एंड स्ट्रेट विथ क्लोज्ड आईज. प्लीज बी अवेयर ऑफ योर normal natural breathing process, how the breathing is happening at its own naturally, your speed of the breath, depth of the breath, how the movement of prana is happening. And now physically, mentally prepare yourself for Kapalabhati, rhythmic and active exhalation, passive inhalation without fluctuation, rhythmic strokes from the lower abdominal region. So you can start first round of Kapalabhati. During Kapalabhati, your focus should be on your lower abdominal region. And with each stroke, you will get the feeling of, slight feeling of Moolbandha. That means Kapalabhati is happening properly. Kapala, forehead or your skull, bhati means shine, to glow, it glows your face, that is why Kapalabhati. And bhati, bhata means a blower of a blacksmith, you know. So how the blower of a blacksmith is working to activate the fire, in the same way your diaphragm is working like a bellow of a blacksmith. So that is why Kapalabhati. Please take rest for some time, let the breathing become normal. So because of this rapid movement of your diaphragm, the active exhalation is happening. Because of this active exhalation, your lungs are getting squeezed actively. That is why the residual air is thrown out. So Kapalabhati is very good residual wash for your lungs. After having a normal breath, you can proceed for second round of Kapalabhati. Our lungs is nothing but one spongy structure in which approximately 2400 milliliter air is stored, which is the stale air known as residual air. And in any other practice of pranayama or breathing practice, this residual air is not getting exchanged at all. Only Kapalbhati is the practice through which almost more than half of the residual air is getting replaced with the oxygen, fresh air. That is why it improves your immunity. Again, let the breathing become normal. So as breathing becomes little fast, so blood circulation improves, pulse rate improves, blood pressure increases. So those already suffering from high blood pressure, they should avoid it or practice it very slowly. You can practice Kapalbhati 1 round, 2 rounds, 3 rounds, 4 rounds, as per your capacity, as per your speed. So not to compare with the others in any yoga practice. Now, again, observe the changes in your breathing pattern. Whenever you will have a normal breath, you will prepare for the next practice, that is known as Agni Sar Kriya. Agni means a fire. So Agni Tattva or fire element is present in our body in the form of gastric fire. This Agni Sar Kriya is done in standing. So I will request Swarup to come in standing. And those Agni Sar, Uddiyan Bandh, Nauli Kriya, those Kriyas, that it should be visible properly. I will request him to remove the shirt so that you can observe those movements and Kriyas very easily and practice it properly, understand it properly and practice it properly. In Agni Sar Kriya, you are supposed to inhale fully first, after that exhale completely. During exhalation, your abdominal region is going in. Keep the abdominal wall tight as it is, and then you are bulging it out and again taking it in. So the 2 and 4th movement of the abdominal wall with control, that is known as Agni Sar Kriya, means stimulation of the gastric fire. Now Swarup is ready for that. So first we will practice 3 rounds of Agni Sar Kriya. So slowly, first inhale, then exhale all the way, complete exhalation, bending at the knees, pressing your palms on your thighs, and then move your abdominal region out and in, keeping the abdominal wall tight. So how many times you are able to move the abdominal wall, it depends on your lungs capacity or breathing capacity. In the beginning, maybe 4 times, 5 times, after the practice, maybe 8 to 10 times, 15 times, you will be able to give that moment. But not rapid moment, not very fast moment. It's a very controlled moment. It stimulates your gastric fire. So that is why very good for those who are having weak, poor appetite, or those who are having weak digestion, for them it is very effective. Before feeling suffocated, you will stop, inhale, take a normal breath for some time, and then again proceed for the next round. As this human body and the nature is created with 5 gross elements, that is ether, air, fire, water and earth. So fire is present in our body in the form of gastric fire, which is responsible for our digestion. Take rest now for some time. After this Agni Sar Kriya, now we are going to proceed further for Uddiyan Bandha. There are different locks, bandhas, locks. Uddiyan Bandha is the lock for the abdominal, lower abdominal region. So actually it's a pelvis region, lower abdominal region, in which again you are inhaling first and after that you are going to exhale all the way, and then you are tucking the belly button, you are tucking your abdominal region in all the way. Imagine that you want to touch your belly button to the spine, and imagine to lift your organs up, not only in but in and up, so that it will create the cave like structure in your abdominal region below the bottom rib. That is Uddiyan Bandh. Again, now inhale first, then with exhale you are bending down, bending at the knees, pressing your palms on your thighs, and then suck your abdominal region in and lifting the organs up, creating a cave-like structure. So exactly from the sternum and bottom ribs, they are clearly visible. You can maintain according to your capacity, maybe 10 seconds, 15 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds also. After the practice, you will improve your lungs capacity in such a way that you will be able to maintain this Uddiyan Bandh for till 30 or 40 seconds also. It is possible by the practice. Once again, I will request to proceed. Observe it carefully, practice it carefully. I will request not to practice without guidance. Please practice under the proper guidance of a proper yoga teacher. Relax, take rest. So this is Uddiyan Bandh. Day by day you can increase the number of attempts of Agnisar also and Uddiyan Bandh also. Okay. Now after this, the further development of Agnisar and Uddiyan Bandh in combination is known as Nauli Kriya. In Nauli Kriya, you are going to maintain Uddiyan Bandh first, and after that you are going to relax your middle abdominal region so that Nauli will come. That is known as Madhya Nauli. When your intestine, your abdominal muscles are coming at the center. Okay. Then after that, when you are shifting the pressure of your palm, then it will shift to your left side and then to the right side. So that is, left side is your Vam Nauli, right side is your Dakshin Nauli. And then Nauli Chalan, rotation like a churner. Okay. So first, in first attempt, I am requesting him to show the Madhya Nauli first. Center Nauli. Madhya means the center. Exhale fully, then going in Uddiyan, and then slowly show Madhya Nauli. See, now two caves are created to the sides and your muscles are coming at the center. This is Madhya Nauli, center Nauli. Now I am requesting him to show in the next attempt Dakshina Nauli and Vam Nauli. Dakshina means right side and Vam means left side. For that first, yes. So now he is showing it to the left side, Vam Nauli, and then now to the right side, that is Dakshina Nauli. So the intestine is shifting to one side. It's not so easy, so, but don't be panic or don't worry about that. By the practice, you will be able to do it very easily. And now, in the third attempt, I am requesting him to show the Nauli Chalan, rotation of the Nauli. That can be from both the direction, clockwise and counterclockwise. That is Nauli Chalan. Okay. It is moving just like a churner, you know. So दिस इज नवली चालन. ओके सो थैंक यू. नाउ विल रिक्वेस्ट हिम टू कम इन सिटिंग. सो आफ्टर प्रैक्टिसिंग दिस अग्निसार उड्डयन बंध एंड नवली क्रिया, दीज आर प्रिपरेटरी प्रैक्टिसेस फॉर एडवांस प्राणायाम बिकॉज इट इम्प्रूव्स योर लंग्स कैपेसिटी, होल्डिंग कैपेसिटी, सो दैट यू कैन प्रैक्टिस कुंभक प्रॉपरली, होल्डिंग ऑफ द ब्रेथ प्रॉपरली. एंड ड्यूरिंग प्राणायाम उड्डयन मूल बंध, जालंधर बंध एंड उड्डयन बंध, ऑल थ्री बंधा शुड बी अडॉप्टेड प्रॉपरली टू गेट द प्रॉपर बेनिफिट ऑफ प्राणायाम बिकॉज द अल्टीमेट एम ऑफ प्रैक्टिसिंग प्राणायाम इज टू चैनलाइज योर प्राणा इन सुषुम्ना नाड़ी, इन मध्य नाड़ी. दैट इज द एम ऑफ प्रैक्टिसिंग प्राणायाम. एंड विदाउट कुंभक एंड विदाउट बंधास इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. दैट इज वाई प्रैक्टिसिंग प्राणायाम प्रॉपरली विथ कुंभक एंड अडॉप्टिंग प्रॉपर बंधास, देन ओनली यू विल बी एबल टू चैनलाइज योर प्राणा इन मध्य नाड़ी और सुषुम्ना नाड़ी. Now sitting comfortable and straight in any position, preferably if possible in Padmasana or Siddhasana, but not compulsory. Or you can sit in Vajrasana, you can sit on the chair, whichever is comfortable for you, and you will be able to sit straight. Because pranayama practices are to control the mind, relax the mind. But if you are having pain in the neck, in the knee, and numbness in the legs or lower back pain because of the sitting position, and your mind is getting diverted towards all those painful areas, how can you get the benefit of pranayama? That is why position should be very comfortable. And from here, we are going to practice now Nadi Shodhan Pranayama. In Nadi Shodhan Pranayama, you are going to inhale through the left nostril, counting the numbers in your mind. Then hold the breath twice of inhalation, double time of inhalation. Then exhale through the right nostril for double time of inhalation. Then inhale through the right, hold for double time, and exhale through the left for double time. In this way, maintaining the round ratio of 1-2-2, you can start. It should be very slow and controlled breathing process. Focus should be on your controlled breathing only. Abdominal region remains under control. You are going to adopt Mool Bandha throughout, contracting your anal sphincters and perineal region throughout. That is Mool Bandha root lock. After inhalation, after Purak process, you will adopt Jalandhar Bandha and then Uddiyan Bandha during Kumbhak. Whereas when you are releasing your Kumbhak, before that you should release your Uddiyan Bandha, then Jalandhar Bandha, and then you start your Rechak, that is exhalation. In between, whenever you will feel tired during those practices, anytime you can take rest. You can relax in sitting Vishramasana, or you can take rest in Shavasana also. I will recommend that practicing pranayama is must. That should be done every day. If you take a leave, if you take off from asana practices, from your any exercise, jogging, walking, gym, whatever you are doing. And if you take a off of a day in a week, doesn't matter. But pranayama practices should be every day without fail. Okay, then you will get a proper benefit of pranayama and relaxation to the mind. After this nadi shodhan pranayama, now we are going to practice the traditional way of practicing bhastrika pranayama, because bhastrika pranayama is practiced in modified way, only active inhalation and active exhalation. But we want to practice bhastrika in a traditional way, in which 40 strokes of kapalabhati, active kapalabhati, at the time of the last stroke you will exhale completely, and immediately after that you will practice one round of surya bhedan pranayama, that is inhalation through the right, holding the breath, and exhalation through the left. That's it. So overall it becomes one round of bhastrika pranayama as per the tradition. Okay, so sitting comfortable and straight, eyes closed. Now start to practice kapalabhati, active kapalabhati. That will be active than the usual kapalabhati. So 40 strokes you can start. At the time of the last stroke, you are exhaling completely. Immediately inhale through the right nostril, Surya Nadi. Count the numbers. Then hold the breath. Adopt Bandha. Double time of inhalation, you are going to hold the breath. That is Kumbhak. After finishing your Kumbhak, then you will exhale for double time of inhalation. That means the round ratio for this Surya Bhedan pranayama is 1-2-2. So 40 strokes kapalabhati and one round of Surya Bhedan pranayama with the round ratio of 1-2-2 with all three bandhas. After exhalation through the left nostril, inhale little for the preparation of kapalabhati for the next round, and again start kapalabhati. 40 strokes. Exhale completely at the time of the 40th stroke, and immediately inhale through the right nostril. Hold the breath, Kumbhak, with bandhas. So there are a lot of things together. You need to concentrate on all those things, adopting bandhas, then counting the numbers, which nostril you are going to inhale, which nostril you are going to exhale. All those things should be together. In this way only it will improve your body mind coordination and it will improve your concentration. And one more round of bhastrika. So this is the actual traditional bhastrika pranayama. This is very good for kapha dosh, but those who are having hypertension, hyperacidity, or suffering from heart problems, they should not practice this, or this pranayama should not be practiced in hot season, in summer. Whereas in winter, it is very helpful. Take rest for some time with the normal breathing, and then as a counterbalance, we'll practice cooling pranayama. That is Shitali or Sitkari. There are two cooling pranayama explained in the tradition. Shitali इन विच यू आर सपोज टू फोल्ड द आउटर एज ऑफ योर टंग्स एंड मेकिंग अ ट्यूब ऑफ अ टंग एंड इनहेल थ्रू द ट्यूब ऑफ अ टंग. मेनी पीपल आर नॉट एबल टू फोल्ड द टंग, सो दैट इज वाई इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू मेक द ट्यूब ऑफ अ टंग लाइक दिस फॉर शीतली, देन द अदर ऑप्शन इज सितकारी, इन विच यू आर क्लोजिंग द जॉज, कीपिंग योर टीथ टूगेदर लाइक दिस एंड योर टंग इज अगेंस्ट योर टीथ and then you are inhaling from the sides and upper part of the tongue like this. When you eat a chili or when you drink a hot coffee and you burn your tongue, that time what you do in that way? So sitkari, cooling pranayama. So whichever is comfortable for you, you can practice it. I will request him to show Shitali pranayam first, if it is possible. As we are practicing it first time, that is why we are going to exhale through both the nostrils as it is. But in the traditional way, you are supposed to inhale through the mouth, hold the breath, and then exhale through the left nostril. That is the actual way of practicing this Shitali or Sitkari pranayam. Both of them are cooling pranayam. So very good, very effective pranayam in hot season, in summer. It gives coolness to the mind, to the body. Even this Sitkari pranayam is helpful for the chain smokers. By practicing this pranayam, you can control that urge of smoking, and slowly, slowly, day by day, you'll reduce the consumption, and maybe in the future, if you are practicing it regularly every day, maybe in the future you'll give up it. That is a possibility. So you are producing a sound, C sound, that is why Sitkar. So those who are having hyperacidity, burning sensation, heart problems, hypertension, okay, then because of the hyperacidity, if you are having mouth ulcer or intestinal ulcer, for them also it is very effective. Shitali and Sitkari pranayam, both are cooling pranayam. And after practicing Bhastrika pranayam, for the counterbalance, you can practice 2-3 rounds of Shitali or Sitkari pranayam to avoid acidity. After this, we'll try to practice Brahmari pranayam. In Brahmari pranayam, you are supposed to inhale through both the nostrils, exhale through both the nostrils, but exhale with the humming sound of a honeybee. Again, traditionally this pranayam is little different. Usually we inhale through both the nostrils, normal inhalation, and during exhalation you produce the sound. Whereas in the tradition, it is said that during inhalation you should produce the humming sound of a male bee, and during exhalation produce the humming sound of a female bee. It needs a practice, but it is possible to produce the sound during inhalation also. I will show you. I don't know whether he is able to produce sound during inhalation, but I will show you 3 rounds of Brahmari pranayam. But the first round is normal inhalation through both the nostrils. Then during exhalation, you produce the sound, humming sound first. And from the second round of inhalation, you will produce the humming sound during inhalation of a male bee, like this. Mm-hmm. लाइक दिस. बट इन द बिगिनिंग इट इज़ नॉट नेसेसरी टू प्रोड्यूस द साउंड ड्यूरिंग इनहेलेशन, सो यू कैन ओनली इनहेल एंड ड्यूरिंग एक्सहेलेशन ओनली यू कैन कंटिन्यू दिस प्राणायाम. ओके, टू मोर राउंड्स इन दिस वे. Keep your eyes closed as it is. Try to feel the same vibrations of humming sound of Bhramari Pranayam. Observe the silence, peace, calmness, coolness, pleasure and happiness around you and within you. And from here, we are going to enter in the stage of Dhyana, meditation.
Welcome to Heartfulness Meditation. Please approach this meditation with an attitude of openness to fresh experience. Heartfulness meditation is aided by a very subtle transformative energy called pranahuti or transmission. Choose a place where you can meditate without being distracted. Turn off your phone or any device that may disturb you. Make sure you're sitting comfortably. You can sit cross-legged or in a chair. Let your hands rest in your lap, loosely clasped. Let your eyes be closed gently. Let your back be upright but not rigid. Feel free to change your posture during meditation if you feel uncomfortable. We will begin with the simple practice of heartfulness relaxation. Once you feel relaxed, you will be guided into the heartfulness meditation. We will all meditate together in silence, so we may feel the peace that surfaces when we turn our attention inward and dive deep into our hearts. Through the heart, we find unity. Through the heart, we create a feeling of well-being. First, relax. Close your eyes very gently, very softly. We will begin with our toes. Move your toes. Relax them. Imagine the soothing, healing energy from the earth moving up into your feet, slowly relaxing them. Feel it relax your toes, the soles of your feet, your ankles. As this energy moves upwards, relax your calves, relax your knees. Feel it relax each and every muscle in your thighs deeply. Feel both your legs becoming totally relaxed. Relax your stomach your waist, your hips. Let go of any tension or stress you may be holding there. And relax. Allow your back to soften. From your tailbone to your shoulders, feel your entire back relaxing. Relax your chest, relax your shoulders. Let this healing energy from the earth melt away any tension or stress you may be holding on your shoulders. Feel your shoulders melt away and relax. As this energy moves down your arms, relax them. Feel it relax your upper arms, your elbows, your forearms, your wrists, your hands. Let the energy flow out of your fingertips, leaving both your arms deeply relaxed. Relax all the muscles in your neck. Bring your awareness to your face and relax it. Feel the healing energy from the earth. Relax your jaws, your mouth, your lips. Feel your ears relax. Breathe normally. Relax your nose. Keep your eyes softly closed. Relax them. Relax your forehead. Feel all the tension, stress, and anxiety there simply melt away. As this healing energy from the earth moves further upwards, relax your entire head all the way to the base of your skull. Feel now how your whole body is totally relaxed. Take a moment, scan your system from top to toe. And if there is any part of your body that is still tense, painful, or unwell, feel it being immersed in the healing energy of the earth for a little while longer. When you're ready, move your attention to your heart. Rest there for a little while. Feel immersed in the love and light in your heart. Now, we will meditate together. Make a suggestion that the source of divine light that is already present inside your heart is attracting your attention towards it. Gently relax into that feeling. Let it be a very light suggestion, without force or concentration. If you find your awareness drifting to other thoughts, do not fight them. But also do not entertain them. Let them be like clouds passing in the sky. Gently remind yourself that you're meditating on the source of divine light in your heart. Be open and receptive to the transmission that will be flowing into you. Allow your awareness to melt into your heart. Remain absorbed within your heart until you hear the meditation has ended. Please start meditation. That's all. Keep your eyes closed for a little while longer and tune in to how you feel. Absorb all the peace that you have experienced. Now, imagine that this peace is expanding outward to everyone, uniting everything around you, and is encircling the world. When you open your eyes, take the time to enjoy the experience. You can write your experience in a journal. It will help you to develop awareness and observation. We thank you for expanding this feeling of peace, unity, and well-being around the world.